Ulysses by James Joyce. Produced and directed by Jeremy Mortimer, starring Andrew Scott as Stephen Dedalus.
The Martello Tower, Sandy Cove and Dublin Bay. 8 a.m., 16th of June, 1904.
Stately, plump Buck Mulligan mounts the gunrest, bearing a bowl of lather on which a mirror and a razor lie crossed. He holds the bowl aloft.
Introibo ad altari dei. Come up, Dedalus. Come up, ye ancient Greek. We must go to Athens. Will you come if I can get the aunt to fork out 20 quid?
Mulligan.
Yes, my love.
How long is Haynes going to stay in this tower?
God, isn't he dreadful? A ponderous Saxon. He thinks you're not a gentleman. God, these bloody English, bursting with money and indigestion because he comes from Oxford. You know, Dedalus, you have the real Oxford manner. He can't make you out.
He was raving all night about a black panther. Where's his gun case?
Were you in fear?
I was. Down there in the dark with a man I don't know raving and moaning to himself about shooting a black panther. If he stays on here...
What?
I'm off.
Lend us alone your nose rag to wipe me razor. Dublin Bay. Come and look.
Our mighty mother.
What?
The scrotum tightening sea. Dedalus.
What?
How are the second-hand breeks?
They fit well enough.
I have another lovely pair with a hair stripe. Grey.
Thanks. I can't wear them if they're grey.
Oh, in mourning, of course. Etiquette is etiquette. He kills his mother, but he can't wear grey trousers. My aunt thinks you killed your mother. That's why she won't let me have anything to do with you.
Someone killed her.
Look at yourself in me mirror. I pinched it out of the skivvy's room. Here.
It is a symbol of Irish art. The cracked looking glass of a servant.
Tell that to Haynes and touch him for a guinea. His old fella made money by selling jalap to the Zulus or some bloody swindle or other.
I'm the only one that knows what you are.
Why don't you trust me more? Is it Haynes?
He can stay if you want. There's nothing wrong with him except at night.
Then what is it? Cough it up. What have you against me now?
Do you remember the first day I went to your house after my mother's death?
Why? What happened in the name of God?
Your aunt came out of the drawing room. She asked you who was there.
Yes. What did I say?
You said, oh, it's only Dedalus whose mother is beastly dead.
Did I say that? What harm is that? I see them pop off every day and cut up into tripes in the dissecting room. It's a beastly thing and nothing else. You could have knelt down, dammit, when your dying mother asked you. To think of your mother begging you with her last breath to kneel down and pray for her, and you refused. You crossed her last wish in death, and yet you sulk with me because I don't whinge like some hired mute.
I am not thinking of the offence to my mother.
Of what then?
Of the offence to me.
Oh! An impossible person.
You up there, Mulligan?
I'm coming. Don't mope over it all day. Give up the moody brooding. Come down like a good mosey.
And no more turn aside and brood upon love's bitter mystery.
Stephen stands, gazing over the calm sea. Pulses are beating in his eyes, veiling their sight.
I sang that song in my mother's house. Her door was open. She wanted to hear the music. She was crying in her wretched bed. And now in dreams, silently she comes to me, her wasted body within its loose brown grave clothes, giving off an odor of wax and rosewood, her breath reproachful, a faint odor of wetted ashes, her glazing eyes staring out of death to shake and bend my soul to strike me down.
Stephen. Stephen.
No.
Let me be and let me live.
Dedalus!
Haynes is apologizing for last night. It's all right.
I'm coming.
I told him your symbol of Irish art. He thinks it's very clever. Touch him for a quid, will you?
I get paid this morning.
How much?
4 quid.
Lend us one. You owe me.
If you want it.
4 shining sovereigns. We'll have a glorious drunk to astonish the druidy druids. Come down now. Breakfast is ready.
Warm sunshine marrying over the sea. His shaving bowl, he's forgotten. Why should I bring it down or leave it there all day? Forgotten friendship.
The Martello Tower, Sandy Cove on Dublin Bay, 8:15 a.m.
In the gloomy domed living room of the tower, Buck Mulligan's gowned form moves briskly about the hearth.
We'll all be choked. Haynes, open that door, will you?
Have you the key?
Dedalus has it.
It's in the lock.
Bread, butter, the grub is ready.
I say, Mulligan, you do make strong tea, don't you?
Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts. Ugh,
by Jove, it is tea. I have to visit your national library today.
Swim first. Is this the day for your monthly wash, Dedalus? The unclean bard makes a point of washing once a month.
All Ireland is washed by the Gulf Stream.
I intend to make a collection of your sayings, if you will let me. That one about the cracked looking glass of a servant being the symbol of Irish art is deuced good.
Wait till you hear him on Hamlet.
Well, I mean it.
Would I make money by it?
I don't know, I'm sure.
You put your hoof in it now. What did you say that for?
The problem is to get money. But from whom?
I blow him out about you, and then you come along with your lousy leer and your gloomy Jesuit jibes. Why don't you play them as I do? Ah, to hell with them all.
Are you coming, you fellows?
I'm ready. Did you bring the key?
I have it.
Do you pay rent for the tower?
12 quid.
To the Secretary of State for War.
Rather bleak in wintertime, I should say. Martello, you call it?
Billy Pitt had them built when the French were on the sea.
I say, Dedalus, what is your idea of Hamlet?
No, no. Wait till I've a few pints in me first. You couldn't manage it under 3 pints, Dedalus, could you?
It has waited so long, it can wait longer.
You pique my curiosity. Is it some paradox?
He proves, by algebra, that Hamlet's grandson is Shakespeare's grandfather and that he himself is the ghost of his own father.
What?
It is rather long to tell.
The sacred pint alone can unbind the tongue of the bard.
I read a theological interpretation of Hamlet somewhere. The father and son idea. The son striving to be atoned with the father. You're not a believer, are you? Personally, I couldn't stomach that idea of a personal god. You don't stand for that, I suppose.
You behold in me a horrible example of free thought.
You are your own master, I think.
I am the servant of 2 masters, an English and an Italian.
What do you mean?
The Imperial British State and the Holy Roman Catholic and Apostolic Church.
I quite understand. Well, we in England feel we have treated your nation rather unfairly. It seems history is to blame. Of course, I'm a Britisher, and I feel as one. I don't want to see my country fall into the hands of German Jews. That's our national problem, I'm afraid. Just now.
Are you coming in here, Mulligan?
Yes! Make room in the band.
Where's the brother with you?
Down in Westmeath, with the Bannon.
Oh, I got a card from Bannon. Says he found a sweet young thing down there. A photo girl, he calls her.
Snapshot, eh? Prefix poser.
Whoop!
Cigarette, Dedalus.
Thank you.
Hey, are you not coming in?
Later, not on my breakfast.
I'm going, Mulligan.
We'll see you again. At the ship.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.